Hello everybody, welcome back to a new video. It's Gina here, and if you're new to my channel, then I'm doing different art related videos, be it art challenges, be it art illustrations like this, be it original fan art, and since a little while I'm also doing tutorial kind of videos. So, as you can see, I'm using my watercolor. Yay! I bought this watercolor set last year? I think it was last year, I don't know anymore. But I really wanted to draw more with watercolor, and somehow, yes, this year again it's on my to-do list, use more watercolors. And somehow I already used more watercolors because I have these watercolor pencils that I really use a lot. But I don't know why I have problems with watercolors and pens, and I just really want to practice it, to use them too. Like, I mean, they're really good, like they're not professional or something like that. They are the Winsor & Newton Cotman watercolors. And they are a lot better, like my, if you didn't see my cheap art supply challenge, where I used my watercolors from school, when I was in school, I used the watercolors that are really cheap, really, really cheap. And these are a bit pricier, but still on the cheap range, and it's not professional, but still a lot better. And I really like them, the colors are beautiful and everything, but I don't know, I don't use them as much as I should, but they are really amazing and I really want to practice with them. So on one day I didn't know what to really draw, and I was like, I somehow feel like I want to draw a kimono girl. And this is what I did. I kind of used the reference for the pose, but other than that it's really just my own thing, because the patterns are all mine, and also I changed her face, her hair and everything. So I know there are some mistakes, I still see a lot of really mistakes and such in here, like with the proportions of her body. And well, I still need to practice a lot also with watercolors, but I also see some things that changed and got better. Like the face, I still see mistakes there, but not as bad as I usually do, and I really need to practice to like skin coloring. I don't know why I have really problems with coloring skin with these watercolors. The funny thing is, actually, when I use the cheap watercolors, the skin on the girl looks really good, actually. And I really need to just don't think about it that much, I think. Because with the cheap art supply, you're just like, okay, you have this art supply, you don't have to be like, yeah, you will try your best, and actually it really worked out. One of the things that I think is really sad that I made, that the thing around her waist, I should have let it be really light and not the dark colors and such. But yeah, also I will add some like golden patterns and white patterns on it. I think there's also something that I really should practice, like giving the drawings more detail and such, because I'm just really like damn lazy when it's going with watercolors or giving some really detailed work. Yes, I'm lazy with that and I should really change it, but you know, I'm already changing, I could say, because I'm doing this 365 draw challenge and drawing or sketching every day something, and not only just trying, like, doing every day this figure drawings. Of course, I do it sometimes because, one, it's practice, second, sometimes even that is really beautiful, but I just really want to, like, practice. Even if I do portraits, I practice with it, the face anatomy. If I do something simple, it's also alright. But I also want to do sometimes something like this, where I just really illustrate a character or something like that. And I can't wait for Mermaid. I really want to try to make as much mermaids as I can and make them look different. Probably I will use some references for fishes so I can make different groups of mermaids. Mermaids. So I will see what I can do, and I hopefully can continue this challenge. And well, I'm just really like practicing a lot because I want to grow as an artist and show myself that I can do it, because often I did do art every day, almost every day, but I was sitting on a piece like days. Like, it's good in a way and it's bad the other way. It's good because I really tried to make the drawing as good as I could. Like, when I had the sketch, then I changed it as much as I could, so I had the refined sketch and everything, and then doing the line art really and letting it dry so that it won't smudge. It didn't matter what I used with it. And well, to be honest, it's in a way good but also bad, because now I see that I can do pretty much refined drawings, even if they have their mistakes. But you know, nobody is perfect, and I don't want to be really, really perfect. I think an artist can always learn, and even after years you can learn a new technique or even more develop or like practice your skills so you don't get rusty, if you know what I mean. And yeah, I just really hope, and a little bit I can already see that this practicing is really helping me, because I don't need that long anymore with my drawings. And also I can really produce every day something, even if it's sometimes something small, because I don't feel that well, or the day was really long with things that get in life and something like that. And it's a really good habit to slowly do something like this every day. And oh my god, this kind of turned into a speech, sorry guys. But yeah, I still hope you like this drawing, even if it has its own mistakes. And if you did like it, then please feel free to give a little like, tell me in the comments, what do you try to make this year, what do you want to achieve, even if it's not art related. Maybe you want to make more sports, maybe read more books or something like that. Just tell me in the comments. And if you want to see more like this, then please feel free to subscribe, and I will see you then in the next video. Bye bye!